For social studies today, we are going to Russia, a country so big it's almost twice as big as China. Let's go! Welcome to Russia! Would you like to play with these wooden nesting dolls? Do you want to go where the sun never sets? How does a bowl of pink soup sound? Let's explore Russia. Russia was once ruled by kings called Khazars. They built grand palaces and beautiful cities like this. Many buildings have onion-shaped domes. Magnificent art is found nearly everywhere. Moscow is the capital. The Kremlin is the seat of the government. The president lives here and he runs the country. The Prime Minister helps him, so does the Duma, which is a group of lawmakers in Russia. The Red Square, which is here, is in Moscow too. It is one of the largest town squares in the whole world. St. Basil's Cathedral is here. The Red Square is in Moscow too. It is one of the largest town squares in the world. St. Basil's Cathedral is here. This is what it looks like. What do you think? Many leaders in Russia have been very controversial. Statues of these leaders are located throughout the whole country. Do you think they should be removed? Why and why not? And then there's Siberia, which is located north. This province is filled with vast natural resources. Like what? There's coal, petroleum, natural gas, even gold. Winters here are very severe. Temperatures can drop all the way down to minus 90 degrees Fahrenheit, which is minus 68 degrees Celsius. Polar bears are also here to fish in the Arctic Ocean nearby. Did you know that in Russia, the Trans-Siberian Railway runs through Siberia? It is the longest single rail system in the whole world. How long is it? Almost 6,000 miles, which is 9,660 kilometers. It was finished in 1916, which is almost 100 years ago, and it runs from Moscow to Vladivostok. And then there's the city of St. Petersburg, which has interesting buildings. It is so far north that the sun does not go down during the month of June. This period of time is called the White Nights. The city hosts festivals to celebrate. People can attend special ballet and music performances. And here we have the national emblem, which can be found everywhere across Russia. The modern design is based off one from more than 500 years ago, and each element has a special meaning. Life in Russia. Most Russians now live in modern cities like this. Families live in small apartments. Grandparents might share the space too, but some people still live on farms like this. They grow grains. What else do they grow? There's also sugar beets, fruits, and vegetables. Many Russians work with computers or in science. Some work in companies that make gas. Others have service jobs. To get to work, people walk or take the subway, like this. Some subway stations are grand spaces filled with art, like a museum. After work, people might hike or ski. Others go to plays, concerts, or the ballet. Most of the best ballet dancers in the world live here, in Russia. What do you think? Why do you think hiking and skiing are popular activities in Russia? And what outdoor activities are popular near where you live? Meals and celebrations. Now the fun part. Russian food is simple and filling. A pink soup called borscht is made from beets. Hot yummy cereal starts the day. It is made with grains. Lunch or dinner might be potato dumplings filled with meat. They are served with cabbage and dark rye bread. Russia's oldest holiday is Maslenitsa. It celebrates the coming of spring. People dress up like this. They play tricks on each other. They also eat blini, which are these thin pancakes. There's also New Year's Day, which is the biggest holiday here in Russia. People decorate trees. Children receive presents. There is so much to do here. What would you like to do here in Russia? Now let's go through some new words we learned in today's book. The first word is capital. which is a city where government leaders meet. Khazars are the emperors of Russia before the revolution of 1917. Duma is the representative council in Russia. Emblem is a symbol or a sign that represents something. Modern means having to do with the present or recent times. Natural resources are materials produced by the earth that are necessary or useful to people like us. Palaces are large fancy homes for rulers. Prime Minister is the leader of a country. Province is a district or a region of a country. Seat is the central location of the government. Service jobs are jobs and work that provide services for others, such as hotel, restaurant, and retail positions. And finally, subway is a train that runs on underground tracks. Now it's your turn. What do you think about Russia, and would you like to visit one day? Let me know down below. And also, share with me what are some things you learned from today's book about this beautiful country. Take some time to think about it, and when you're ready, I'll see you in the next lesson for some more learning fun. That's all for now. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.